So Australia, UK,
US. So this was a new grouping recently formed in Indo-Pacific region. In Indo-Pacific region. So Indo-Pacific in the sense Indian Ocean region, Pacific Ocean region. Indian Ocean region, Pacific Ocean region. The only ocean which named after a country is Indian Ocean. And India always believes that Indian Ocean is India's ocean. India always believes in Indian Ocean is India's ocean. But I think maybe that is not true. We wanted to be, but that is not true. But anyhow, recently, when Russian foreign minister has commented on this AUKUS and Indo-Pacific, he said, it's better if you say East Pacific. Don't call it as Indo-Pacific because they don't want India to align with this. Russia don't want India to align with this group. But that's a different story. But why this Australia and UK and US has came together? What are their interests? Why there is a separate group? And what is the role of India? Because there was another group which was already started in this region called Quad Group. And you know the countries of Quad. So India, US, Japan, Australia. So these are the countries, Quad countries. No, we have formed this Quad country. Actually, the Quad was an idea of 20 years back. Japan was mooted this Quad idea initially because we wanted a group to secure the ocean or the sea routes because China is expanding, whether they have started, but ultimately it has become a reality when Donald Trump is the president of United States of America. Under this Quad, what we have thought is, so we will secure the oceans. We will secure the oceans. They will call it as freedom of navigation on international waters. Freedom of navigation on international waters. International waters are for everyone to use, but some of the countries are occupying the international waters. They are maintaining their own hegemony by creating the artificial islands. Artificial islands. Just I'll give a simple example. Why actually this hegemony is coming means, suppose if India is having its own coast, from the Indian coast up to certain distance you are having the rights. Up to 12 nautical miles you will have some rights. Up to 200 nautical miles you are having a separate right. Up to next to 12 nautical miles you are having a separate rights. This we call it as exclusive economic zone, transition zone. These are the things. So if you have your mainland, to some extent you are having your own influence. Now what China is doing is, in the middle of South China Sea, China is artificially creating the islands and claiming that islands as their mainland, and from that mainland again they are extending the 200 nautical miles of kilometers. Okay, so that is how China is started gaining its control in the water. So by creating the artificial islands in the South China Sea. And it is not only in the South China Sea. China is controlling, I think just now I have told you the string of pearls, like how it is creating its own military bases, how it is controlling the trade in the entire region. So we wanted that China's presence should be contained, because it is also creating a lot of problems to Taiwan also. So what United States of America has thought is, if we allow the hegemonic attitude of United States of America, then China can control the entire Pacific and as well as the Indian Ocean. Somewhere we need to contain China, we need to reduce the influence of China. For that, we need to have an active presence in the waters of both Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. That doesn't mean that America till now have no presence in this. America is having, UK is having, Russia is having, France is having. But they wanted to do it at an active way with the help of these countries like India, Japan and Australia. And if you're looking into India, Japan and Australia, these three countries are having rivalry with China. Japan is having its rivalry with China, and you know India is having its rivalry with India is having its own rivalry with the China. And when it comes to the Australia, recently the war or whatever the relations between Australia and China are, now they have strained. Australia said, I don't allow the 5G company of China, Huawei, in Australia. And there was a trade blockade between Australia and China. And even there was some arrest of some of the spies and some of the intelligence people. Lot of mischiefs are happening between Australia and China. So now China is not maintaining a good relations with Japan, not maintaining good relations with Australia, and not maintaining good relations with India. That is the reason why United States of America want to have a group with these countries. But America, since inception of the Quad, consistently denying that we are not against anybody. We are not forming a group against anybody. It is on our own self-interest. We wanted to promote the openness in the oceans or the international waters. We wanted to respect the international agreements. This is what America is saying. And when it comes to the India, it is very difficult for India to put its arguments forward because we don't know exactly why we have joined in this Quad. We don't know exactly why we have joined in this Quad. Simply we say like, okay, we will do trade relations, we will do other relations, we will do some political relations, we will do some investment, we will just patrol it, we will just do exercises. That is what India started preaching. And last year there was a question like, Quad is not a security block, but now it is extended to a trade block. It is extended to a trade block. See, I can argue that, okay, extending it to a trade block is a good thing. We can maintain good relations with America, Japan, Australia. That doesn't mean that we don't have trade relations with earlier. We don't know with what purpose we have started the Quad. We don't know. Just we are saying something, but we are preaching different. And ultimately, this was extended to different areas called exercises, trade, investments, and other relations. Other relations it extended. Somewhere, United States of America has thought so seriously. If we don't contain this Chinese attitude in this region, it is very difficult because now the China is developing, and it's not only developing, but China is gaining its own control in different parts of this Asian and South Asian and Southeast Asian region. And suddenly before the Quad meet, America has called for another group called this AUKUS. AUKUS. Now India is saying, okay, AUKUS have nowhere related to Quad. AUKUS is not going to affect on Quad. Quad is something different. AUKUS is something different. We are not concerned about AUKUS because our relations are so strong. We are making our relations with the Quad. Our relations with the Quad countries so strong. That is what they are saying. But what you have done on Quad? No, nothing. No progress. Just because you formed a Quad, what extra benefit that you got? That is the reason why there was a diplomat called T.P. Srinivasan used to write articles in Hindu, and he has written an article, for what purpose we are making all these groups? Is there any theme to that? Just because you came together and you don't know why you came together and you have formed a group. Did really India achieved any extra benefit because of this Quad? Okay, some trade increase. The trade increase, is it because of Quad? Or because of the inherent nature of relations that already existed between India and US, India and Australia, and India and Japan, but still we wanted to project Quad is a different group. Now the point is, okay, India can project in any way. India can project in a positive way. But what America is doing with Quad and AUKUS, when America is already a partner in this region, along with Japan, Australia, and India, why it has necessitated for America to align again itself with Australia on the name of security? Because the same security you have preached earlier when we have formed the Quad group. But again, why you are forming a different group? Because the reason is India is not interested in making this security alliances. Because today, under the name of AUKUS, it is a trilateral security partnership. They are going to share the nuclear submarines. Now, Australia and America, now they are going to maintain the submarines combinedly in the Indian Ocean and even Pacific Ocean. Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. And UK has also joined into this. I'll come to that, why UK has joined in this group. And till now, America has only given this nuclear technology, nuclear submarine technology, to UK only. Apart from that, it did not supply this technology to any other country. Now it has given to only Australia. So India don't want to make these security alliances. If India don't want to do a joint patrol with the other countries, because India has took a very strategic position that after LTTE attack on Rajiv Gandhi, India decided that we should not maintain any military alliances with any other country. If you want any assistance, we are ready to provide, but we don't make any military alliances with any other country because we are against to that military alliances. Because in the Cold War era, there was a capitalist bloc and there was a socialist bloc. But we have maintained equal distance to the both capitalist bloc and socialist bloc because we don't want to be part of these military alliances. We are ready to maintain any relations, but we don't maintain these military alliances. That is what India's position. And United States of America understood very clearly that if you go with India, we don't get anything. So it's better to shift the stance. And they went to Australia. Now they are saying it is a security group. It is a security group. Security group for what? Security group for what? To securing this Indo-Pacific waters. To securing the Indo-Pacific waters. Then what about Quad? Is it not for securing the Indo-Pacific waters? No, they are saying like, no, Quad is something more wider and Quad is having a different notion. So Quad is different and AUKUS is different. Now again, why America want to again maintain? Because they wanted to contain the Chinese presence. Now, how China is looking into this entire aspect? China is calling it as a Cold War mentality. Now you are promoting an arm race in this region. Till now we don't have any problem. Just because you have a problem and you have entered into this region and you are making an alliance and re-alliance in this country, it is something against the multilateralism. No, you are targeting one country. You are not supposed to target one country. If you want to make an alliance, you can make the alliance. But you can't make an alliance just to target one country. And you are targeting me. And China is saying, I don't accept all these groups. And now in retaliation to this Quad and AUKUS, China and even Russia, they are coming together. They are coming together in this region to contain the American influence in the Indo-Pacific region. Again, in the Indo-Pacific region, why UK has entered into this? What is the role of UK? Why UK enter into this? Because UK now, after post-Brexit, now it has become alone. Now it cannot align with the European Union because there is a strong rival called France and Germany. They were there. They are already part of EU. Now UK is alienated. UK want to ascertain itself with the help of United States of America. They are ascertaining. And UK is now seeing, because the world is completely shifting from west to east. Now, because you can imagine the population of China, the population of India, how much amount demand is there in this country. Any country in the world, if they are producing, if at all they want to have a market, they must come to the Asia. And there are Asian tigers are there, like Southeast Asian countries. Take the case of Japan, take the case of South Korea, take the case of Singapore, Malaysia, Philippines. These are all now moving in the growth direction. Now, UK wanted to have their own presence in the Southeast Asian region. So that is the reason why UK is entering into this. But now the problem is we don't know, because UK can also align with the China. But because of the historical reasons, UK don't want to align with the China because Chinese policies are more concerning. Because China has already entered into the UK. Because China is also influencing the UK region also on the name of One Road, One Belt project. The One Road, One Belt project is entering into even Europe also. So to contain the Chinese presence and in order to gain something in this region, UK is also entering into this. And UK's presence is not new in the Indian Ocean region. I am going to give some of the list of the bases that UK is already having in the Indian Ocean. It is having its own bases in Bahrain. It is having its own base in Oman, Kenya, Brunei, Singapore, Qatar, Diego Garcia, Diego Garcia. It is in Chagos Island. The issue is happening with Mauritius and this. So that means UK is already having all the bases here, because I think in the world, United Kingdom is the one which is having a highest strong navy in the world. That is the reason why it has won in the World War II. At that point of time, even your Germany, Russia, no one is having such a naval power. And because of that historical naval power, it is having the bases in the Indian and Pacific Ocean. It's already there. But to strengthen the security, to strengthen its economy, to increase its dominance, and also to uphold the value system called the international freedom of navigation, and this entire region is not a new thing to the United Kingdom. Is it new thing? These are all colonies of Britain at one point of time. These are all colonies. Now, after left the Brexit or the entire European Union, maybe United Kingdom want to ascertain on its own. Maybe that is the reason. We don't know. That is the reason. That is the reason why they are entering into this region. They are entering into this region. But one thing, again, you have to be very careful about this entire exercise is, I just give a comparison to you. See, United States of America has entered into the state of Afghanistan because it has its own problem. The problem is not your problem and problem is not my problem. It is only America's problem, because Osama bin Laden has took a shelter in Afghanistan. That is the reason why they have entered into the state of Afghanistan. India is also facing a problem of the terrorism from the Pakistan. But I don't know. Even I am believing that. Do you think that America can really solve the Indian terrorism problem which is emanating from Pakistan and Afghanistan? I don't think so, because we believed that America can strictly contain. But even the 11, I think from 2001 to 2021, this was United States of America has its own presence in the Afghanistan. It has strictly controlled the Pakistan. But attack on Parliament, attack on Bombay, when it happened, when America was present in the Afghanistan, we thought that America can save us from the terrorism. But unfortunately, America has not saved us from the terrorism. America has not saved us from the terrorism. America has entered into the Afghanistan because it has its own self-interest. And once its interests are over, now it is leaving. Now India is in a very dilemmatic position that what we should do with respect to Afghanistan. And now you are having a relation. Now you are having some problem with the China. That is why you are forming a groups called Quad Group, AUKUS Group, another group you are forming. But tomorrow, if your interests are completed, then if you leave, if really India follows along the path of United States of America, now tomorrow, India should also face the same situation in the Southeast Asian region and South Asian region. Today, what we are thinking about Afghanistan, tomorrow we have to think about those regions. So the point is, India is not so concerning about its own region, but rather it is moving with the United States of America. That is what the major policy shift that we can see. We can say like America can give many things. America is going to give many things. But to what extent America will really provide the assistance? And in the 20 years, really to what extent? So, United States of America is having its own interest in Afghanistan. That is the reason why it has entered, and after that it has left, because it has its own problems. Now it is having the problem with the China. That is the reason why it is entering into the Indian Ocean and the Pacific Ocean. And if tomorrow, after its ambitions got fulfilled, and if you don't want to be in this region, suddenly it will move away from this region, then how India will really approach and how India will make an entry into this region is a big question. Because simply you cannot go with the other countries. See, when it comes to the Asian countries. So what are the Asian countries? What is this Asian Association for? Southeast Asian nations, 10 countries are there. 10 countries are there. We call it a Southeast country, Southeast Asian countries. And in this Southeast Asian countries, now how United States of America is going to enter into this? Because these countries are they have not aligned with either China or with United States of America. They are having their own developmental trajectory and they are developing on their own. But now you are entering into this region. Did really Asian countries are going to accept you? You don't know. You don't know. And maybe Asian countries may think that why America is intervening into our own region? Maybe we don't want to allow this hegemonic attitude in this region. If they really think in that way, and if India simply go along with the America, tomorrow you will have a problem with the Asian region. Because when Asian people are thinking about their region, why India is not thinking about its own region? Why India is simply saying like, okay, China has a threat, that is why that is the reason why I'm inviting everyone into Indian Ocean. And if you invite everyone into the Indian Ocean, do you know tomorrow what will happen? Now everyone is bringing the submarines. Already I told you, Chinese submarines are there, American submarines are there, Russian submarines are there, France submarines are there, now Australian submarines will come. Now whatever you said earlier, Indian Ocean is India's ocean. Now Indian Ocean has become everyone's ocean. Then it is very difficult thing for you. Are we really thinking about the militarization of the Indian Ocean region? This is the very biggest threat that India is going to face because of this AUKUS. And did really how Australia is going to play an important role here? Ultimately, if really Australia is becoming an isolating power in the entire Southeast Asian or entire the South Asian region, what about the role of Australia after few years? So we don't know how Australia is going to behave, because earlier Australia was signed an agreement with France for this nuclear agreement, and abruptly Australia has cancelled this agreement with France. Now they have signed an agreement with the United States of America and United Kingdom. And United Kingdom and United States of America, United Kingdom and France, they are not having good relations at all. If you're looking into India and France is having very good relations as far as our military is concerned. There is one more aspect that did really Australia will cross the India's nuclear capabilities? The capacity of Australia will be increased than the India because of the support from the United States of America and UK. If really the Australia's nuclear power is enhanced or increased compared to that of India, then what is the role that Australia is going to play in the Indian Ocean? Today we are against to China, not because just we have a border relation. China is intruding into our Indian Ocean. That is the reason why we are against to that. But if tomorrow Australia enters, if tomorrow Australia becomes more nuclear power, if tomorrow Australia's naval power increase, then what India will do? We don't know. We cannot say like Australia cannot enhance its nuclear capabilities. We cannot say like Australia cannot enhance its military capabilities. But if tomorrow it crosses the India's power, then how it is going to affect? So the point here is your Indian Ocean security itself is in question. That we have to be very careful. Today we are saying like, okay, maybe if United States of America comes, then China will listen to United States of America, then we can bring a balance in this. And when Putin visited India and he is so upset about this AUKUS, and India has not said anything about AUKUS. And India has been maintaining a traditional position that we don't allow anyone into Indian Ocean. But today, how come United States of America, along with UK, are making an alliance in the Indian Ocean? Is it not your responsibility? But you want to contain the China because you think that China is rival. China may be your rival, but tomorrow Australia can also become a rival. Is there any guarantee that Australia cannot become the rival to you? So the point here is what India is thinking, it is just China. That means if at all I want to conclude in one word, I can say that the geopolitics of India is unfortunately decided by US-China rivalry rather than the interest of India. rather than interest of India, all the geopolitics of India are decided by US-China rivalry. And because US and China is are rivals, that is why you are going with some groups, and you are not so well about your own interests. You are not going with your interests. That is an unfortunate thing. Now that is happening in the Indian Ocean region. In the Indian Ocean region, we must move out of this Indo US China rivalry group. You may say that no, we are not like that. We are with Russia, we are with China, we are with some other countries. But did really Russia is believing you on this front? A very big question. No. And when Putin came, the very interesting part in this discussion is we were silent about China's attack on the northern borders of India. They were silent about this AUKUS. And they are consistently criticizing this AUKUS. And moreover, when Russia and China, they wanted to unite against this AUKUS, then how come you expect that Russia will help you? No, it's not possible. Maybe Russia has a lot of defense equipment. They need money, they are exporting. Not that India must be so secured enough. No. Because they have their own business deals. Why America is entering into every country? Do you think that America want to protect every country? No, America is having a lot of military equipment. They want to sell it out. That is their own interest. When every country is so specific about their interest, did really is India so specific about its own interest, or it is just going with the rivalry of the different groups at the multilateral level and global level? This is what we need to have a serious thing. And today you can go with the AUKUS, or you can go with the Quad group. But tomorrow you have a rival called China. You have a rival called Pakistan. Do you think that really all the groups will come and will save you? No. You have to conclude a bilateral agreement. You have to conclude a peace agreement. You have to conclude a ceasefire agreement. You and China is having a lot of problems, but you have to sort it amicably. Don't think that if I bring America here, I can solve the problems. You don't know whether it will be solved or the problems will be much more aggravated. So don't make this bilateral issue into a global issue. Because, see, you have a problem with somebody. You are bringing somebody into this issue, but that person is having a larger interest than you have. And you may complicate the issue. It's like how it happened in our personal lives. That is the same case will happen in international relations also. So India must be very careful about this. Now India must redefine what exactly the Quad, for what purpose we are here. First, we have to define what is Quad and what is the purpose of Quad. Simply, you cannot say like it is not against any country. We wanted to group together. But how will you group together? What extra you want to fetch out of this Quad, you have to be very clear. And what is your role of AUKUS? Are you concerning about this nuclear agreements? Are you concerning about the security of Indian Ocean? Are you concerning about the UK and Australia rival, UK and Australia friendship, and the role of France in this? Did really France help India to increase or to enhance its nuclear capabilities? I don't think so. France and India relations are only transactional in nature. So these are all going to be affected. And this leads to arms race, groupings. So these things you must keep it in mind. And the entry of United Kingdom into this region is bringing different problems. Earlier we are having only problems with the United States of America. That means if you want to conclude an agreement with any country which is having a rivalry with the United States of America, we have lost in case of Iran, you have seen. But if UK also enter into this region, again we have to be very careful before you conclude an agreement with both UK and the rival power of UK. So the point here is the global power you are bringing to solve the issue of China, but unfortunately it may make the issue so complex. And moreover, our regional interests are first must be met. So to solve a problem, you cannot create another problem. And unfortunately, we are creating that problems. Okay. So is it clear with respect to AUKUS? Did you understand anything? Did you get any point? So by showing Taliban as a pretext, USA has entered into Indian Western region. Now by showing the China as the pretext, now they are entering into eastern part of the country. And still we are believing that America is our friend. It don't do anything for us. But it is not only America. Now America brought in another player. America brought in another player called UK. So how India has to think about all these things? You must have an idea. Okay, so this is about AUKUS. If at all you will get a question on AUKUS, you will get mains question. You don't get prelims question as of my knowledge is concerned, because all the preliminary information is known to you. But the point here is you have to be very careful. The security of the Indian Ocean is the first point. Second point is India's regional interests are second point. Third point is how Indian foreign policy is influenced by the rivalry of US and China. Third point. So like these points you have to highlight from the entire this story. You have to highlight these points. These are the things. And we need to define the roles of Quad and the over militarization of the Indian Ocean. So these are all the things you must be very clear about that.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, what is our relationship status with these countries? Cambodia, Vietnam, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore.
Actually, we are
located in the South China Sea, near to South China Sea.
See, as far as these countries are concerned, we are not maintaining the relations at the individual level, but as a part of ASEAN, we are maintaining the relations. But unfortunately, because we don't want to join in this RCEP group, because of not joining into the RCEP group, definitely we are going to affect a trade relations with these ASEAN countries. But even we don't join, we are maintaining a considerable amount of trade with ASEAN groups. But when it compares to the China, we are far, 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 far minimum. So we are not having such a strong relations with the ASEAN as far as the trade is concerned. And we wanted to develop infrastructure to the ASEAN countries, but unfortunately we could not complete all the trilateral highway, India, Myanmar, Thailand highway. But when it comes to the securing the ocean, I think these countries are not so interested in the Chinese involvement in the Indian Ocean. But only some countries like Philippines, Vietnam, Malaysia is having some problems with the Chinese presence in the South China Sea. But just because these countries are having some problem with the China in South China Sea, I cannot say like they will simply go with the United States of America because they have the problem with the China in South China Sea. But America is thinking like by showing the Chinese presence in the South China Sea as a pretext, I can turn all the Asian nations into my side. But to what extent America will really succeed in this aspect? But as on today, the Asian is not a key player in protecting or in securing the Indian and Pacific Ocean region. They are not a major players. They are only confining themselves to what all the trade and related things. And even today, they are not the major players in the region as far as the geopolitics are concerned. But as far as the trade is concerned, they are good players. But unfortunately, India is unable to utilize it to full extent. Is it okay?
Okay, sir. Don't you think we need to make more relations with these countries than US, because we can make bases in South China Sea?
That's what. Actually, we started maintaining our relations with the Vietnam. Vietnam, we are also having a defense relations. But the time when we wanted to maintain good relations with these Asian countries, suddenly this concept of RCEP came. Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. And we don't want to join in that because it is going to hurt the Indian economy. That's where we have missed the bus. But some people are saying like, see, you can argument for both the sides. The thing is, okay, if we sign an agreement, all Indian industry, small people, farmers will get affected. But on the other hand, you will miss a bus. Now you can't join in that RCEP. So it is very difficult to maintain a relations with the ASEAN. Very difficult because China is already having a partner in this ASEAN and they are accepting. And if at all they want to maintain a relation, they will prefer China over India. They will prefer China over India. That is the thing. But the point is, whatever the slogans that we are giving called neighborhood first, we have to implement it properly. We have to be very careful. Just because you have a relation with some external country, you cannot damage your relations in your region, because the relations in the region is very, very important along with the relations at the global level. Global level. Okay?
Sir.
Yeah.
Can we say that we are not having a good relation with our neighborhood countries, not because that we are interest, we are favoring America's interest, but rather that we have a primary anti-terrorism ideology with us?
See this, okay, understood your question. This anti-terrorism ideology, that's what we are having. I think to some extent that is creating a lot of problems to India. See, I'll tell you an example. See, China is not favoring the Muslim Islam countries. If you see the Xinjiang region, who are these Uyghur Muslims are there. Uyghur Muslims are there. Even today, China is considering these Uyghur Muslims as a terrorist. Because China is doing a lot of tortures and they are doing all its human rights violations in the Uyghur Muslim region. And China can also make Pakistan and Afghanistan as a rival, just to showing these Uyghurs as a pretext, because Uyghurs are having their own base in Afghanistan. That's what the Chinese contention. But even though China want to contain the Uyghurs in a different way, China want to maintain a relation with the Afghanistan in a different way. But what we are doing? No, because terrorism is emanating from the Pakistan, we don't maintain relations with the Pakistan. The terrorism is emanating from the Afghanistan. Now the terrorists are become the rulers of Afghanistan. So it's very difficult to accept there as a rulers. But the same problem China is also facing, but China is dealing in a differently, in a different way, in a different way. And suddenly, and we have, to some extent, we have maintained a good thing. We have done a correct thing in case of Myanmar. Otherwise, just because going with America, we say democracy, 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 Aung San Suu Kyi, Aung San Suu Kyi, Aung San Suu Kyi, we will miss the bus in Myanmar also. But we haven't done that. We haven't done that. We wanted to establish a democracy in the Myanmar. That doesn't mean that we won't maintain relations with the military forces of Myanmar. So the point is, what is your interest? You have to be very careful. Your interest. See, there is a problem with the China, because China is entering into Indian Ocean in the Sri Lanka. You can make it with Sri Lanka, no? You can deal with Sri Lanka. Why you need to bring some other country here to deal that? That is the problem. That is the problem. So, and that whatever you said, like anti-terrorism, like policies are, to some extent, they are damaging. And we don't know to what extent really this terrorism is damaging to India. But on the name of this anti-terrorism, on bilateral front, I think we are not maintaining a good thing. But whereas the statement you have made, sir, India is not maintaining good relations with the neighborhood. See, I am not saying like India is not maintaining the good relations with the neighborhood. But as far as the balance of power is concerned, where is your balance? Because power must be balanced. If you take... Power must be balanced on both the sides. Power must be balanced on both the sides. On the one hand, the China is, the policies are completely tilting towards the China, but you are not giving enough balance in your region. That's the point. Not that we are not maintaining good relations, but that must be balanced. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Any other?
What do you think India should do to maintain a balance of power here, especially considering the reason why China is so dominating all these regions is because of its money power, economic power, and we are not anywhere near as rich as China. So in the absence of that money power, how do you suggest, or how do you suggest we maintain this balance in this region?
So actually you are saying like when we are not so rich enough China, how can you really bring the balance in the Indian or in Indian region? See, the point is when you're looking into the international relations, if really the money alone can dominate the entire relations, because so I can understand that China is dominating because China is having a money power and China is bringing lot of investment. That is the reason why they are tilting towards China. But today, tell me, Russia is also having lot of influence in some of the parts of the world. It's not, I'm not saying like Russia is having a vast power, but to some extent in some countries, Russia is able to do. But do you think that Russia is really an economic power? No. Russia is not an economic power, but still it is maintaining its influence. In European Union, France and UK is also maintaining the influence, but they are not economically rich. But the point here is we can make only relations, we can make relations only when we are having that financial power, or otherwise we can make relations only through this economy, but there is no other route to maintain the relations is something not correct. You can bring in another thing like military cooperations, military exercises, soft power is there, diaspora is there, people to people contact is there, cultural contact is there, democratic value system is there. These are all the things are there. But apart from that, whatever the China is bringing, is really the Chinese model is correct? Are the states are so happy with the Chinese model? No, they are not happy with the Chinese model. Because of their political benefits, some of the power, some of the politicians in the some of the states, they are moving, but the Chinese development model is a debt trap model. Chinese model is a debt trap model. Why can't you expose it? I'm not saying like you need to bring such a financial power, you need to take such a financial resources to that country to really develop. No, do you think that every country in this world want to develop on just Chinese money? So the point here is relations cannot be maintained only because of financial resources. That first point you need to understand. Second point is you can make a relations with other aspects also. Third point is as far as this Chinese financial strategy is concerned, we must expose what are the problems in the Chinese model. We have to expose what are the Chinese model. We have a great history of non-alignment movement. Who has started this non-alignment movement? Is it China? No. All the developing countries have started. Do you think that when they have started, do they have such a financial power? No, they don't have a financial power. But on some ideas, on some ideologies, on some philosophies, on some value system, we have started our group. So such a value system, again, we can bring. How we can completely at one point of time, America has started imperialism. Now on another point of time, Russia has its own imperialism. Now China is bringing its own imperialism on the name of globalization. On the name of globalization, perhaps we need to think it in a different way. Why can't we come together? Because we are after all developing world. We don't have such a imperialistic tendencies. Such a thing we must bring into the minds of these countries. And moreover, above all these things, India should not change its policies towards a particular country just because some big power has changed its notion. No, you have signed an agreement with Iran. Iran, suddenly why you have changed? Because America has changed. But I'll ask another question. S-400 missile system is there. If you purchase S-400 missile system, you will get the sanctions from the America. Just because you are going to get the sanctions from the America, have you stopped purchasing S-400 missile? No, because your interest is there here. And you think that Iran is not your interest. You think that America is more interested than Iran. Such a policy shifts will always damage to you. And what about the Nepal policy? Because I don't want to bring you people don't have much idea about Nepal. What about Nepal policy? In Nepal policy also, we have done all these mischiefs only. Not that China is so powerful to bring a lot of money to Nepal. India is not capable of to bring money into the Nepal. The money is not an issue in case of Nepal. Money is not an issue in case of Iran. But your changing stance is the issue. So these stance must be very clear. Very clear. That is what exactly you need. Whereas in case of this India's diplomacy. Okay?
Sir,
yeah.
In case of Quad, can we say that it's been a very, it's actually not that successful because the objective of Quad was to maintain a free and fair maritime relations in Indian Ocean, but that was not in case of China, we was not able to maintain that.
When it comes to the Quad, definitely I can say that, who can say like Quad is a very successful organization? Even with the, I'm agreeing with your point, Quad is not at all a successful thing, because in my mind, I have already put an argument, we don't know why we have started this Quad. Today we can say like, okay, we are extending so much in this area, that area, just because to support the Quad, you can write many articles and you can write many things. But do we really know the relevance of Quad? What exactly the relations that you will maintain? And you are not even neighbors. Japan is somewhere, Australia is somewhere, America is somewhere, India is somewhere. Except that naval exercise. What is that exercise we call it as? Malabar exercise. Except Malabar exercise, you don't do anything with that. Except Malabar exercise. That is the only thing we are doing. Okay, we are saying like, okay, we want to export the vaccines and we will transfer some of the technology. So we are extending our relations even in medical field also. Just because you have exported the vaccine, is it complete? I'm not undermining the relations, but just because vaccines are exported in the pandemic time, is it really strengthening our relations in medical field or pharmaceutical field? The point here is, even if you don't have a Quad, we can have that relation. So I'm agreeing with your point. In making the success, or in bringing the relevance of Quad, or in promoting the Quad, or in taking the Quad much more forward, I think it's not only India, but none of the countries is so interested in this. Because America's interests are something different. You have formed a group. Now America, to really fulfill its own interest, it has formed another group. Now, America no way bring any security issue here. Apart from security, what all other issues you will bring here? Trade, commerce, investment, those are already there. But that is something what we need to have a very serious look on this, whether where we can really put a full stop to this Quad. We cannot something like a bluff the people of this country by naming that Quad. We are having a much more better relations with America, Australia, Japan, what we are maintaining through the Quad. We have all military agreements with America. Lemova agreement, Jismova agreement, GIS agreement. You will study all these agreements. But in Quad issue, I think we are not proper, that I can say. And I agree with your point. Any other?
Amrita, IAS Academy.